For more analysis on China's manufacturing sector and economic recovery, my colleague Rachelle Akuffo spoke with Yan Liang. She's a professor of economics at Willamette University. And Rachelle began by asking her what accounts for China's continued recovery in manufacturing.
So, you know, the PMI just eased very slightly from 51.9 to 51.3, as you pointed out. So I think one of the reasons is, you know, as China is closing, it is coming close to the spring festival. Some of the factories may pause the production earlier and let their workers go back earlier for the spring festival reunion. Because of the coronavirus and the protocols of testing and self-quarantine, so I think some of the workers would leave the factories earlier so they can stay home and, you know, get all the protocols done before they can, you know, join the family for the festival. So I think that might be one of the contributing factors. Yeah.
And we certainly did see that manufacturing companies do maintain a positive outlook when it comes to their businesses over the next 12 months. What do you think is really boosting that confidence?
Right. So, you know, for one, I think manufacturing sector is a little bit less vulnerable to the pandemic, especially when China, you know, is very effective in containing that. So unlike services where you have more person-to-person contact, manufacturing sector is a lot less vulnerable. So I think the manufacturing sector, it's able to weather through the, you know, the pockets of outburst of the virus. And the export order is still strong. And I think, you know, domestically, the government stimulus is still at place. So all of these, I think, help to boost manufacturing production, where service sector, I think, slowed down a little bit.
Now, I want to focus on exports. I mean, how are they faring now versus where they were a year ago?
Right. So last year, China has achieved pretty good, you know, export performance, you know, compared to the rest of the world where, you know, the exports and imports were slowing down. China's export last year actually rose by 3.6% and achieved, you know, more than $300 billion of trade surplus. So I think this year, you know, there will still be a pretty consistent demand for China's, you know, exports for medical equipment and PPEs and et cetera. You know, it might be softened a little bit as, you know, as other countries are trying to get their pandemic under control. But I think, you know, there's still a very robust demand for, you know, Chinese products, you know, ranging from electronic products to all kinds of, you know, household appliances, etc. So I remain pretty optimistic for China's export performance.
And what about the stronger yuan currency? How do you see that affecting exporters?
Right, so that does, you know, squeeze some of the profits of the exporters. But I think, again, you know, the appreciation of the RMB is a pretty slow-going process. Last year, we see about 7% of appreciation. So for some of the very thin profit margin industries, they might get a harder hit. But again, this is a slow motion change. And so hopefully the exporters and producers are able to come up with ways to cope, for example, by boosting their efficiency and, you know, trying to remain more competitive. And I think overall, from the big picture standpoint, it's a good thing for China to upgrade its manufacturing, you know, to get more value added to, you know, sort of cope with the appreciation pressure.
Now, it might seem counterintuitive, but China's actually seeing concerns about a factory worker shortage. Break down what's driving it, how some of these owners are addressing it, and what this might mean longer term.
Right. So I think the biggest issue is the demographic changes, right? So China is an aging society. And so the population peaked, you know, by the turn of the century. So it's normal, you know, just like any other advanced countries, China is slowing in getting into that sort of the labor shortage era. So looking long term, of course, that's why, you know, the government has put so much emphasis on innovations and technology and, you know, trying to boost productivity so that, you know, with the labor shortage, China is still able to maintain the productivity and to maintain to be sort of the world's powerhouse for manufacturing.
So then as you look at some of these key economic growth drivers, what are you keeping an eye on and which ones do you think still need more support?
I think definitely the service sector, especially, you know, now that China wants to boost domestic demand, that I think a lot of consumption would be in the form of consumption of services. And services, like I just talked about, you know, they're much more vulnerable to the virus. And so what we see actually from the PMI, the service sector, or construction and service, the non-manufacturing sector's PMI actually dropped from 55.7 to 54.2. It's still in the expansion territory, so service sector and construction sector are still expanding, but that they are slowing down. And one of the reasons, again, is because the resurgence of the virus, and also the Spring Festival, where the travel has been restricted now. Typically, 1.7 billion trips will be taken in normal year, but this year we're estimating more than 40%. Actually, last Sunday there were about 7 million trips have been taken, and that is already a 75% reduction from a normal year like 2019 and 20. So I think the service sector will remain a little bit weak. Probably, hopefully by the end of February, things will start turn up for the service sector.